Hey, Dr. Flight here. In this installment, we are going to spend a little bit of time defining and describing products and services. So the core offer, or the offer that is offered by the organization, is the product or the value that's being created and then distributed to a market segment by the nonprofit. So we want to define that value and how it is delivered and the different nuances of it. And so we'll draw from product theory, from marketing and business in general, to define what a product is, its different components, and also distinguish between a tangible product and a service. So that's what this focus will be on. Let me know if you have any questions. Alrighty, we are going to spend a little bit of time talking about products and services. This is always a real fun topic. I love products and services and the way we work with these. Initially here, let's spend just little time looking at definitions of products and what makes the difference between a product and a service as such. One way to think of products is to think of it as a set of components or layers. In this model that you have here, there are three layers: the core, actual, and augmented product. And the way this basically works is the core product, sometimes the essential product, is the basic benefit that's being provided as a result of the product or service that is being offered. So think of the need or want that the customer is trying to satisfy. That's what's being defined in the core product. The tangible product, or the actual product, includes what the physical aspects are of the product. It can also include brand, however, and quality. So not all things you feel, but things that are associated with the product, the actual product features, the packaging, the branding, the appearance, and such. Augmented products are really fascinating. Augmentations to a product typically associate themselves with services that you use with the product in order to make it easier to use the product, or something more accessible for the product itself. So at the fundamental level, the core product is the client's need or want that's being satisfied. Think of hunger, shelter, learning, safety, protection, aspirations, and so forth, right? The core needs to be satisfied by many different solutions from very broad varieties of firms and also nonprofits. Firms, nonprofits find it difficult sometimes to differentiate themselves from the core if they don't add services to it. So when you think about the core, think about transportation. Like, I need to get from point A to point B. The core in this case may be satisfied by many different solutions. Like, you could walk, you could run, you could ride a bike, you could ride a scooter, you could take a boat, you could ride a plane, you could ride a train. I feel like Dr. Seuss. There are lots of different things I could do in order to solve that specific core need. So there may be a lot of substitutes here, but think of the core as a basic need or want. The challenge will be for nonprofits to be able to compete against each other based on some differences. And if you can't distinguish your core need that you're satisfying as opposed to somebody else's, then you're going to have a problem. So we need to move outside the core if we want to compete. It's basically the bottom line. But the core is the fundamental thing that you're trying to solve from the customer's perspective. So let's move outside the core to the tangible or actual product. The tangible product is where much differentiation exists in the physical form that the product takes. Product variations exist here. While the core is still being satisfied, the core need is still being satisfied. What we're doing is we're finding different ways to satisfy it. Look at this picture of the car and all the different product features that are associated with this particular car. every one of these offers a point of differentiation, and it defines one car from another car, or the distinctiveness from of one to another. So think about how you can change your service or your product based on its features, its styling, quality, packaging, branding, the different types of component parts that are made out of it, or if it's a service, its process steps. So again, at the core level, there are lots of solutions to a customer's problem because the problem and is the core, and the core is the problem. Once we get out of that arena to the tangible or actual product level, then we can have a lot of distinctiveness, and we can clearly define, oftentimes we can clearly define our product from our competitors' products. And that's actually, incidentally, what we use to sell our products. This is how we, these are the arguments we use to sell somebody on an idea. The third stage, then, the one that I find most interesting most of the time is the augmented product. So, product augmentations are ones that we make to the product that help the customer use the product more so. Augmenting the product further helps a nonprofit to customize its products and help our clients adapt to them, and adapt to unique markets and market needs that are out there. So again, we're further differentiating ourselves from our competitors, but this time we're using services. Typically, they're services that are associated with the actual product that we're offering. So financing, spreading payments over time, warranties, special deliveries, multiple time offerings. If you're again in a religious organization and you have multiple church offerings, or if you have a yoga class and you're offering at different times of the day, other advice, instructional support, hospitals who offer a website that has healthcare information on it, for instance, support groups. Adding support groups is a good way, fantastic way for you to augment your service if you're a nonprofit. Offering financing and things like that. How about a warranty? We will provide you a warranty against overeating if you use our services. If you go back to overeating, we will give you your money back or something. I don't know. That's kind of a weird one. But anyways, so augmentations, again, services typically that you can associate with your product that help your customer use your product more or make it easier for them to use your product. So those are cool kind of three layers to the product. Let's spend a little time though talking about services. One concept that is kind of interesting is that most offers that are made include a tangible element and a non-tangible element. So, having a pure good, a pure tangible, and or a pure service are fairly rare. But we have something to help us understand this a little better called the goods services continuum. So, when we look at the goods services continuum, we think about a range of products and how we may have a physical product, but then we may also have a part of that physical product that we include a service for. Think about fast food restaurants or any restaurant, for instance, like in the middle here, you get the actual physical product. But then you also get like speedy delivery or hot delivery, or you get a waiter or waitress who's very knowledgeable about the menu, who can give you advice. Those are all elements of service. So that places restaurants sort of in the middle of this chart, right in the middle there. So combinations then of tangibleness and like actual physical products and services are more the norm than they are. If you provide a service and you're way over, so teaching is considered a service and not very tangible, but if you're able to provide some type of physical component to the actual product, like a university campus, for instance, then you added a physical element to the teaching element, and it's created a better product experience for your customers. So let's spend, though, a second or two talking about services. There are five different elements or components to services that make them unique. I've already mentioned this idea of intangibility. So services typically are not something that you can hold, but we want people to be able to see them. So we often use logos and like notations or marks of some type. We could use websites to create some type of visual effect. Variability. So the variability element means that there's a change in or inconsistency in performances. So imagine if you go to a theater and you go to a matinee of the theater, or you go to an evening performance of the theater, and you notice that the singers are a little off key in one part, or somebody misses their lines between one rendition and another rendition of the performance. Well, that indicates that there's a variability or a variation in quality. So that's something that we need to look at or consider that's unique to services. Also, something called inseparability. Again, consider the theater idea. When you go to a theater performance, you're watching actors who are delivering lines and they're acting in their style, in their way. It's difficult to separate, in other words, the actor and the performance that you're seeing. They're one and the same. They're inseparable. So that's kind of the idea. When you buy a physical product, you're buying the physical product and you're not so much buying the worker who made the product. You're buying the physical product, and that's really kind of you're distinguishing between the physical product and the person who actually made it. So that's an idea in services that are unique, this inseparability notion. Perishability, and then finally involvement. These last two elements are unique to services. Perishability is that notion that services cannot generally be stored or saved or held into the future. Their effects do not last. Involvement generally means that the client has to be more involved in order to gain the value and the experience. So they have to participate generally, even emotionally and physically. They have to generally participate and take in some level of understanding of the product in order to appreciate it. Consider going to an art gallery. There's art on the wall, but really what it takes is the customer, client, to walk and look at it and think about it and observe it and, you know, kind of gravitate to it emotionally. Once they do that and become involved at that level, then they actually see value in it. So it's kind of like an involvement degree that's required in order for the value to be realized. So wrapping this up then, again, this was just kind of a fun topic. I love talking about products and different types of products and the variations and characteristics of products. We talked about three different layers of a product: the core, the tangible, and the actual and the augmented layers of the product. We mentioned the goods services continuum, and then we finally outlined five different unique elements of services. It's intangibility, inseparability, variability, perishability, and then finally involvement. So this has been a fairly straightforward, quick review. Again, if you've had a principles of marketing class, then you've reviewed these types of things. We can certainly incorporate these concepts in the nonprofit organizational perspective. Services tend to play a much stronger role in nonprofits. Usually we are focused on the service side rather than the good side when we're dealing with nonprofits in general. But you know, the principles apply though that you've learned in regular traditional marketing to also use in a nonprofit arena as well. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions. Thank you for listening. I hope you have a fantastic day.